CYC is a free channel that presents the Word of God for everyone. Your support will help us to continue the mission. Visit our website, cycnow.com. Even a dollar will make a difference.
Angels of the Earth is the name of our new program. In this program, we will ask many questions about the monastic life. We will learn more about their vows and practices. The orientation of the monk is towards heaven, towards the life of another world. They are frequently referred to as earthly angels. What is more blessed than to imitate the chorus of angels on earth? For this reason, we will try to highlight the monastic vocation, which we may answer some of the questions that the youth have asked. We are very blessed with the presence of Abuna Arsenius. He's one of the monks here in the Abbey. And we thank you for taking the time to answer some of our questions. Okay. First, I would like to know a little bit about your life before you decided to join the monastic life.
Well, first, I would like to thank everyone on the team for all the efforts. I have gotten closer to God since I was 13 by my servant back in Egypt. And he encouraged me to attend the Midnight Praises on a weekly basis. And from there, I started developing this emotions towards God. And the emotions grew more and more. And under the supervision of His Grace Bishop Yusuf, I came to live for the rest of my life for God in the monastery, in this monastery, St. Mary Somerset Abbey.
So that actually helped you make the decision that monastic life will be the right choice for you by loving praises and hymns?
That's a huge part of it. It's because praising God is a way to express our love to Him. And back then I was young, of course, but I left the options open, and the love of God just grew more and more in my heart. And eventually it became my decision since after I was done with school, my college, and I was about 23 when I joined the monastery, and the voice of God was clearer and clearer. But of course, praising God is a huge, had a huge impact on me. Since I was a young youth.
So what is really the meaning of the word monk or monasticism?
The word monk comes from the word monachos in Coptic, which means solitude. Mm-hmm. And it's a way to live alone with God, to reach that unity with God, just to have a complete unison with God.
Okay. What is the difference between the solitary life and the cenobitic life, and if one is better than the other, especially when you're talking about hymns and praises? I'm not sure if the solitary life will be a good option to practice this praises and hymns.
Right. Saint Anthony the Great started the monastic life, of course, and it was a life of solitude. So every monk would stay alone in a cell or in a cave in the deserts. And later they started to group up and form groups and become a monastery. Later, Saint Bachomius, the establisher of the cenobitic life, he started groups of monks, and they lived together in one building, and they would eat together, and they share the place, and they praise together. Later, Saint Macarius the Great, kind of got them both together. So the Macarian monasticism is every monk has his own cell or his own cave, and he would praise God alone. And at the same time, they would meet during midnight praises and the liturgy, and they would praise God together. So he kind of united the Antonian or the St. Anthony monasticism with the St. Pachomian monasticism. And this is what we're living right now. So each monk has his own cell, which he can praise God alone. And at the same time, there's the midnight praises every morning and the Holy Liturgy, and we praise God together.
But does this mean that if you are not interested, or if someone is not interested in praises and hymns, cannot become a monk?
Of course not. There's lots of stories in the Paradise of the Fathers that some monks didn't know how to read or write, and they didn't have the talent of hymns or to learn it, and they were saints. And it's just a way. It's not a goal. It's a way. Praising God is a way to express our love to Him. So the Church established this way to praise God, to love Him from all our hearts, and to help us. It's just an aid to help us get to heaven, and to help us unite with God. That's our main target. But it's not a must. But it's highly recommended.
Yes. Yeah. So going back to your personal experience, how did you hear the call of God for you to follow this path? What were the signs that you felt like this is God's call for me, that I should pursue it and continue in that way?
Well, for monasticism, it is more of a choice along with the calling. Calling for service, it is a calling, pure calling, but for monasticism, it's a choice. So one makes the choice to live with God. So like St. Anthony said, there are three types of people that live in monasteries in monasticism. The first is the one that is out of fear of condemnation. The second is out of a repentant life, that he needs more time to repent of his sins, and the third out of a pure love to God. Eventually, the first two lead to the third one, which is the life of love to God. For me personally, it started as a zeal in my heart since I was about 15 years old, and I shared it with my father, confession, and I shared it later with His Grace Bishop Yusuf, and everyone throughout the path guided me through it. To be open to all the options, and whether marriage or monasticism, and eventually the voice of God came clear and clear. How it came clear, it would become clearer than the sun. I guarantee that it would be very clear to anyone that seeks this life personally. So God will make sure to send the message. He will make sure that you would get the message that He wants you in monasticism. There's no doubt about that, and it would only mean complete sense to you.
So if one wants to test himself and to see his ability to become a monk and his ability to persevere all the challenges and the difficulties that he may face when he becomes a monk, what are some of those tests before starting the monastic life?
Well, like we all know, there are three vows for monasticism. There's the vow of poverty, the vow of chastity, and the vow of obedience. And just to answer this question, you might want to consult with the Father of Confession to what exercises I should take to follow these vows. For example, for obedience, as an example, you might want to visit the monastery and practice obedience to every monk, to every brother, to everyone, even back home, to your father confession, to your parents, to servants, or anyone, as long as it does not contradict the commandment of God. And if you can endure it, then it is a strong message. Then you might want to just visit the monastery more often, give it more time, and see if the zeal grows bigger and bigger in your heart. Along with these vows, there is, of course, the solitude part, which you can practice sitting alone with God in your room, or when you visit the monastery or in churches, just alone and spend time with God and see if you can endure it over and over. And another, of course, is praising. And if you can attend midnight praises or liturgies and you find enjoyment in those praises and those services, then, of course, that would be something to help you get, unite with God throughout the way.
Mm-hmm. So if you were to describe the monastic life in one word and explain it, what would that word be?
I would say from my standpoint right now, it would be praise or praising. As of now, I'm in charge of hymns and teaching hymns and the church hymns and church services. And it's such an enjoyment. It's great. It delivers the message to God. It gives us the way and the path to express our love to God with all our emotions. And some of us know that there are types of prayer. There are the vocal prayer, and then the second degree is when we understand, like the mindful prayer. We understand what we're saying. And the third is when we feel it. And the fourth is the ecstasy or theoria, some people call it, and that's the highest. Yeah. And we have to start with the first two. The vocal means we have to be consistent with our prayers. We have to attend. This is why all the monks attend midnight praises every morning at 4 o'clock, and with eagerness and enthusiasm to praise God.
Yeah, I'm sure that's heaven.
And the second is we're trying to understand what we're saying. And third is comes from God when he makes us feel his existence, and the fourth is really high, and it just when it comes to a point that we're not doing anything other than just staying in his presence, and all four exist in the paradise of the fathers, and it's very monastic. It just gives us the way or a mean to reach or to express our love to God.
Exactly. So, do you teach other monks, or are you participating in any activity that will help other monks reach this kind of love?
I'm trying.
To praises?
Yes. We have two classes, two different classes. One for beginners, like the easy hymns, and doesn't have a lot of melody into them. And the advanced classes, or like the longer hymns, and it needs more concentration. We have like a chorus of monks, actually, and it gives us the spirit of angels. That's what angels do. They praise together, just like we read in the nativity story. They were praising together. And if we're trying to reach heaven and praise God in melody, then we have to start now. And so we're trying to get there by learning these hymns.
Okay, with this we end our questions with you, Abuna Arsenius. Thank you so much for being with us today.
Thank you so much.
Visiting the earthly angels is like visiting the earthly paradise. They are true citizens of heaven. They renounce the world on a journey to a life of a virtue, enriched for perfection. A monk dies to the world to find life. Reject worldly wisdom to the spiritual. Denies himself to find himself in God. From St. Mary and St. Moses Abbey, we thank you for joining us. Hope to see you next time with the Angels of the Earth.